Hey there, it's Mr. Olson. How's it going?
So, this is our video for October 18th or 19th.
Yeah.
Problem 1, 3x plus 11 equals 29. Actually, try these out on your own, pause the video, and we're back. I'll go over two of them with you. How about this one and that one? So, subtract 11 from each side. 3x equals 18, divide by 3. Divide by 3, x equals 6. Checking your solution. By the way, you should show work. If I just see x equals 6 on your paper, there's a good chance that I won't be giving you full credit on your notes, alright? Your note score, part of that is that you are showing complete work. It'd be just like if, in English, you didn't write in complete sentences. Your teacher would be justifiably upset that you did not write in complete sentences. Especially if they said to write full paragraphs and you just wrote a sentence. Then that's not full paragraphs. I want you to be showing your work. I want you to be checking your solutions. If you just have this, that your solution, you may be losing points. In fact, I will at some point randomly collect your warm up as you start class, and I will grade that warm up as a homework assignment. That I'll look at it and say, "Huh, they didn't show any work on this. They lose points. They didn't check the solution. They lose points." That's what I want you to be doing. And if you're not doing that, you're not doing what I've asked you to do. For full credit. So why would you expect to get full credit if you're not doing the full thing? So when we substitute x in there, we get 3 times 6 plus 11 equals 29. 3 times 6, that's 18. 18 plus 11 equals 29. And 18 plus 11, hey, that is 29. Yay, our answer is right. Yay. 4, z divided by negative 4 plus 7 equals 15. Subtract 7 from each side. So z over negative 4 equals 8, multiply by negative 4. Z equals negative 32. Now, I substitute that back in. Negative 32 divided by negative 4 plus 7 equals 15. Negative 32 over negative 4, that is 8. 8 plus 7 equals 15. And 8 plus 7 is 15. Yay! Okay. Today's objective, we can perform operations on numbers in scientific notation. Yeah. Class business, the usual stuff. Box stops, bring them in. Leaving, let me know whenever you're going to be leaving. Thanks for those of you, if you're watching this right now and you told me ahead of time I'm going to miss this day. That's excellent. It's good of you to let me know ahead of time so that I can plan on you being off. Quizzes. We didn't have a quiz today, but make sure you keep up on your quizzes. Make sure you retake any of the ones you need to do. And if you're going to retake, please make sure that you study ahead of time or arrange to get help from you ahead of time, because it's no use doing a retake if you're not getting a better score, and you're not going to get a better score if you just wander in and retake it. Good thing, because it's good right now. As soon as I finish making this video, I get to go on fall break. Can't wait. It's going to be great. Okay, so, operations and scientific notation. The trick to this is all multiplication here. We can change the order of multiplication. In fact, the parentheses are just there to show scientific notation. So we can change this to 3 times 2 multiplied by 10 to the 4th times 10 to the 3rd. Now, 3 times 2, that would be 6. 10 to the 4th times 10 to the 3rd, 10 to the 7th. This would be like you had, basically, you could think of this as 3 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 multiplied by 2 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10. Or 10 times 10 times 10 times 10. 10 times 10 times 10, yes. Then we can rearrange the order on that, 3 times 2 times all those 10s. Which 3 times 2 is 6, and then all those 10s, 10 to the 7th. 6 times 10 to the 7th, see? But basically, what we want to do is just multiply the exponent parts of it together, or the non-exponent parts, 3 times 2, 6. And then your exponents, 10 to the 4th, 10 to the 3rd, with our properties of exponents, you add those together, 10 to the 7th. Try that out on these problems here. Pause the video. And a wrap. So here, 2 times 4, 8. 10 to the 3rd times 10 to the 7th, 10 to the 10th. Here, 1 times 7, 7. 10 to the 6th times 10 to the 3rd, 10 to the 9th. 8. 5 times 6, 30. 10 to the 12th times 10 to the 3rd. 10 to the 15th. Now then, that 30 changes to 3, basically, because we can't have two decimals like that. The decimal place needs to be right after the 3, so we need to move that over one. So that 10 to the 15th would change to 10 to the 16th.
We decreased it here. So that decreased when we moved the decimal place over. So that needs to increase. 3 times 10 to the 16th. Try that out on these ones here. When you multiply them, you'll get 2-digit numbers that you have to convert. Pause. And we're back. 3 times 4, 12. Times 8th and 5th, 13th. Now we move that over by 1. 1.2 times 10 to the 14th. This one, 7 times 5, 35. 4th and 2nd, total 6th. Now we need to move that over, that decreases it, so we need to increase that power. Decrease, increase. It's all got to balance out. 3.5 times 10 to the 7th. And which other one should I do? Let's go with this one. 9 times 3, 27 times 10 to the 14th. Got to move that over. Decreased, increase. 2.7 times 10 to the 15th. On the next set of problems we'll do like this, there will be some that have negatives in them. So let's just quickly review adding and subtracting negatives. Pause the video, try these out. And we are back. So on number 17, this equals 2. 5 plus negative 3. If you've got opposites, you subtract. 5 minus 3 is 2. And then keep the sign of the bigger number, positive. This ends up very similarly, positive 2. If you have two negatives, just add them together and keep it negative. A negative 5 and a negative 6 makes a negative 11. 20, you should have gotten negative 3. 6 minus 3 is 3. The negative is bigger, negative 3. 21, you should have gotten negative 5. 22, negative 13. 23, positive 1. 24, negative 3. Hopefully, okay, write the problems down, alright? If you're just writing down a 2, a negative 11, a negative 3, a negative 5, a negative 13, a 1, and a negative 3, you've not really accomplished too much. You've not really done a lot to help yourself to learn. By writing each one of these down, writing the problem and the answer, you make it so your brain remembers, right, this is a negative and a positive, we subtract here, and the answer is positive because the positive is bigger. The more you're writing down, the more you're cementing that in your brain remembers that. And it was amazing to me as we did this lesson. I didn't have these problems in there originally. In fact, you can see that the numbering system breaks down there, despite all the times that I swear I have changed the numbering to make it match. I added those in because all the kids were struggling with these ones here. They kept making mistakes. So we added in some extra addition and some addition practice with the negatives. That means that you guys, a lot of my students, aren't quite good enough at this yet. If you're in that category, they made mistakes on some of these ones, write out the entire problem, alright? Writing it out cements it in your brain more. Every time you're writing it out, you're making your brain more and more aware and more sure of that. So that when you actually see it in a problem, you're not having to stop and think, well, I've got a negative and a positive, what do I do? No. Okay, so this one here. Oh, try these out. Pause the video. Okay, so here this would be 27, 9 times 3, 27. Times 10 to the, let's see, negative 6 and 8. So negative and positive, they're opposites. Subtract 2. The positive is bigger, so positive 2. Move the decimal over one spot. So that becomes 2.7 times 10 to the 3rd. This one here, 8 times 6, 48. And then we've got positive 4, negative 8. So that's opposites. Subtract 4. The negative is bigger, so negative 4. Now, 48, we need to move the decimal over 1, that decreased this, so this needs to increase. 1 bigger than negative 4 is negative 3, 4.8 times 10 to the negative 3rd. Remember, because it's negative, the increases and decreases are kind of opposite feeling, aren't they? Try out number 15. So that would be 10 times 10 to the negative 7th. Add those up, because they're both negative. In the same way that two positives add up to make a positive, two negatives add up to make a bigger negative. Now move the decimal over. Decreased, so it needs to increase there. 10 times 10 to the or 1 times 10 to the negative 6. Okay. Dividing. How about that? Try this out. Think about on your own what this might equal. Hint, it's very similar to what we did with multiplying, just dividing instead. Okay. Hopefully you came up with 4 times 10 to the 3rd. That we have those 8s that divide to make a 4. And then these that divide. And our rule for dividing two exponents is that you keep the same base, but subtract it. 5 minus 2, 3. Try that out on these other examples here. Go. And we're back. So, 9 divided by 3 is 3. 10 to the 15th over 10 to the 8th, 10 to the 7th. Here, 7 times 10 to the 4th. Here, that 1.6 is kind of tricky, isn't it? Is there a number that's better than 1.6? Do not round, do not round. Is there a number that's kind of like 1.6, but would be easier to divide by 8? Hopefully you're saying, well, yes, Mr. Olson, there is, 16. Maybe we'll figure out what the power is in a second there. So 16 divided by 8 will work much better. So we made this number bigger. That went up. That means this power must come down. Times 10 to the 8th. 16 divided by 8 is 2. So 2 times 10 to the 6th. Try out these ones here using a similar method to what we just did. So you'll need to convert this. If you're making it bigger, the power goes down. Pause the video. And we're back. So this one should have 27 times 10 to the 9th. Over 9 times 10 to the 3rd, which that would be 3 times 10 to the 6th. Which one should I do? Let's go with 30. 30, 56 times 10 to the 11th, over 7 times 10 to the 5th. Wait, we can't change that. We need to move that down. Ooh, my iPad is informing me that I'm low on batteries. Okay, good, still recording. Divide that, 56 divided by 7 is 8. 10 to the 8th over 10 to the 5th, 10 to the 5th. And this one I want to go over with you because that negative there. So, on the top we change it to 28th times 10 to the 10th over 4 times 10 to the negative 7th. 28 divided by 4 is 7, so 7 times 10 to the, here's the tricky part, 10 minus negative 7. Now what do you get when you subtract, have two negatives in a row like that? It becomes 10 plus 7. I have some students that by instinct they know this. They don't have to think about it. Me, I don't. Do you know why I don't? Because I have done that so many times. So many times I've rewritten this as that, that my brain like permanently knows if there are two negatives in a row like that, it equals a plus. It becomes a plus 10 plus 7, not 10 minus 7. Try out these negative problems here, kind of like the positives from earlier. We really struggled with these. Rewrite it each time if there's two negatives in a row. Rewrite it with the plus there instead. Pause the video. And we're back. 33. This is like negative 7 plus negative 8. So two negatives added together, negative 15. If you got that wrong, go back and rewrite it this way so you're thinking, oh right, it's two negatives added together, which makes a negative 15. And fix any other ones that are like that that you made the same mistake on, like this one here. Okay, 34. So 5 minus negative 3, that's 5 plus 3, which is 8. If you're making mistakes on any of these, I highly recommend you be writing out the entire problem and writing out the changes, like that. Negative 6 minus negative 8. Negative 6 plus 8, that is 2. 4 minus negative 8. 4 plus 8, 12. Negative 3 minus 7, so that's negative 3 plus negative 7, which is negative 10. Negative 12 minus negative 3. So that's negative 12 plus 3. Opposites, we subtract 9. The negative is bigger. Negative 9. 4 plus 5, 9. Negative 6 minus 2, minus negative 2. Negative 6 plus 2, which is negative 4. Okay, and try that out on these ones here. We've got all sorts of negatives. It's all kinds of fun. And you've got to like modify them too. It's super fun. Okay, pause the video. And wrap. So this one, we need to change that to 35 times 10 to the 11th over 5 times 10 to the negative 4th. So 35 divided by 5 is 7, 10 to the negative 11th times divided, or 11 minus negative 4, that becomes a plus 15. Let's do this one here, I like it. So 24 times, now that 10, it's negative 11th, we need to decrease the power by 1, so negative 12th. Over 4 times 10 to the 3rd. Now then, negative 12 minus, or 24 divided by 4 is 6. Negative 12 minus 3, negative 15. This one here is sort of fun. 3 doesn't divide by 6 evenly, does it? There's two different ways I've seen this done. One way is you could move that over by 1, giving you a 30. So 30 over 6, which divides evenly. So 30 times 10 to the 15th over 6 times 10 to the negative 4th. 30 divided by 6 is 5, 15 minus negative 4, positive 19. Other way to do that, some people do 3 over 6, which would say is 0.5. 16 minus negative 4 is 20. So 5 times 0.5 times 10 to the 20th. Move that over. That's increasing the number, so decrease the power. And that gives you 5 times 10 to the 19th. Well, hopefully this went well for you. Hopefully it made sense. If you have any questions, bug me. Feel free to do so. Have a good one. Bye.